What's up, everybody? Welcome back to The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. We are here with Geralt, or, well, maybe we aren't really here with Geralt, but we're here with Geralt in spirit. I'm so used to saying it, and maybe I just miss saying it. It's only been a couple days, but I already miss saying it. Sometimes I just wake up in the morning and, you know, first thing I think about, we're here with Geralt, right? Geralt, you here? Anyways, what I want to do is I want to go ahead and look at the trailers that we actually missed because, well, spoilers, we weren't able to actually watch them since we just got done with Witcher 3. All the way to the end, and we're, you know, finally done. We can go back and look at these trailers that we have not seen and just react to them. The first one of which is the 10th anniversary of The Witcher. And then I honestly think I'm just going to go around. Well, now that I can, you know, actually just go around without seeing spoilers since we already beat the game, I'm going to look through The Witcher YouTube page and I'm going to look at some of the other trailers and then react to them. And I've seen some stuff in there about, well, The Witcher Con. There were some things with songs in the WitcherCon, so there's something I want to look at too. Let's look at this one first and then see what it's about, and then we'll just take it from there. Here we go.
Hey, was just reminiscing and realized, damn. Been ages since we last saw each other. You know me, got a hard time staying put. Though, Regis says I'm getting old. Drops in with herbs for Triss sometimes. Strange species I've never seen. They grab Yennefer, lock themselves in her lab, spend all day brewing. Wouldn't dare interrupt them. Not that I'm complaining. Gives me time to help the guys with their contracts. Although, can't shake the feeling they mainly take jobs nearby. Lambert practically lives here. As I said, find it hard to sit still. Except, things are good here, you know? I'm good. We play Gwent, drink wine, swipe grapes from Anarietta's vineyards the odd moonlit night. Vesemir'd enjoy that especially. Been through hell and high water, you and me. Fact is, you know me better than anyone else does. Actually, I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you. Thanks for everything. And know we all miss you, old friend. So, might be my birthday, but I say, here's to you. Now, tell us how you're doing.
That was amazing. Whoa. Teared up. Yep. Knew that was gonna happen. It was basically a continuation of what's been happening at Corvo. Wow. That is so awesome. Thank you so much for doing that. I can't believe they actually did that, but I'm so happy they did. Actually, I can see them doing this. It seems CD Projekt really, really loves the fans. They do. And I would say that they really love Geralt and the Witcher story in general. Well, hell, they made this 10 plus years of their lives, if not even more, of making, oh, actually it has been more, longer of a time since they made, you know, Witcher 1 and then all the way in Witcher 3. But let's go back a little bit. Let's look at I want to look at all the people. Look at fucking Zoltan cheesing over here. We even got Johnny. Look at our man Broach back here, and there's Roach right there. There's Broach and Roach. Dandelion back here, we got Triss, Lambert. Fucking Regis again, Ciri, Yennefer, Shani, Eskel. Got the whole gang, friends. Man, that was so good. I really feel like I might be running out of tears now. Every time I see something with The Witcher, it's just, they just hit us in the feels. They know how to just bring us up or knock us down and then bring us right back up again. Obviously, the end of Witcher 3 was so good and it hurt just to say goodbye, but it's so awesome to see that everyone is here together and they all came to Corvo. Lambert's basically fucking living here. Where's Kira Metz, Lambert? Did she throw your ass out?
Probably.
Lambert's got himself a Kira Metz twist off with, like, Geralt and Yennefer. You know how Geralt and Yennefer always break up and get back together? Well, Lambert's got the same thing going on. Wow, that was so good. A standing ovation. Unbelievable. Did you see Ciri just walking in? That was amazing. Look at her. Giving BB a hard time. You better be whooping his ass at Gwent, girl. What else do we have? I feel like I've seen Anna Henrietta in here.
They grab Yennefer, lock themselves in her
lab. Oh, there's Kira Metz right there.
Brewing. Wouldn't dare interrupt him.
Ogierd's in there too. Look, there's Ogierd.
Not that I'm complaining. Gives me time to help Baron. The guys with their contracts. Although, can't shake the feeling they mainly take jobs nearby. Lambert practically lives here.
Look at Ciri right here. Oh my goodness, I love this so much. The Bloody Baron. The fucking Bloody Baron is here. Get out of here. You see Johnny just running around having a great time? Ogierd is here. Get the hell out. Where's Odin? You know he's back here somewhere. Renzo is so good. Look. There she is. She's singing again. Priscilla. There's Vess. Sianna's here. Wow. Get out of town, man. Look at Damien. He's back there just chilling. That was so good. I feel like I want to salute him nonstop. Just keep on saluting. All right, let's look at something else because I'm going to sit here tearing up if we keep looking at this again. All right, this one is The Witcher 3 launch trailer. Like I said, I've been just keeping away from everything possible when it came to spoilers to The Witcher 3. When we went into The Witcher 3, what did we react to? We reacted to the Killing Monsters trailer, and then we reacted to the Orianna trailer. Get the fuck out of here. Fucking Orianna. Crazy. But this is the launch trailer. I can't wait to see what it actually is. So let's just look at it. Let's watch it. Let's take it in. Memories. The Hangman's Tree, remember?
I
The memories. The memories. It's so crazy because all the stuff in that, you know how trailers tend to use, they don't want to use every big thing in a trailer. Well, maybe they actually probably do want to put every big thing in a trailer. So, you know, obviously the game sells, but The Witcher 3 has so many awesome scenes and so many big things that every single one of them scenes were just, like, amazing. They were all the great points of the game, but there's so much more scenes that they didn't show that was absolutely amazing. What I'm getting at is they have so many great scenes that they can't just fit it all in a trailer. It's just too many of them. This one is called The Celebrating the 5th Anniversary of The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. Let's go ahead and watch this one, huh? I love this background. It's so freaking cool. I might even want to take this and put it on my computer as the wallpaper. Look at Yen. She looks so good. Look at Ciri, Triss. We got a Foglet, Ekamara, Plague Maiden, probably. Harpy. Look at Aridin's bitch ass. Fucking Animal Breath. All right, let's go ahead and watch it. Come on. The music. The best. Now that is a group of talented people. Holy moly. Did you hear the vocals on that? Sending shivers down my fucking spine. Making me tear up, obviously. Like I said, I don't have any more tears, but they're coming out of nowheres. I'm borrowing them from you guys, I guess. Because we're all tearing up on this. That was really good. I don't know how many times I sat there and complimented about the Witcher music, but the effort and the time that they put into the music in this game was extraordinary. I've already said it. What can actually beat The Witcher at this point with anything? The game music is this. Yes, I've been listening to the soundtrack nonstop. I have waited about a year and a half to finally listen to the soundtrack, and it is great. Amazing. I don't even have words for how good it is. It's just playing nonstop. I go to sleep and, well, I'm, instead of counting sheep to sleep, I'm sitting there thinking silver with monsters and the swamp music, and then the Bloody Baron. So it's just so many good ones. That was so good. Let's look at some more, huh? I don't want to call it quits yet. The Sword of Destiny trailer. This one came up quite a few about reacting to this one, so let's get to it. Let's see what it is.
Once we were many. Now we are few. Hunters, killers of the world's filth. Witchers, the ultimate killing machines. Among us, a legend. The one they call Geralt of Rivia, the White Wolf.
We meet again, Witcher.
Your Imperial Majesty.
She's returned, Geralt. After all these years.
Are you sure it's her?
Yes. And she's in danger. Witnesses claim the Wild Hunt follows her. You must find her.
And when I do, what then?
I shall give her what she deserves.
The whole situation with Amir there. What was that about? That was all new. Hold on. Look at this. Is this what they wanted to do and maybe cut it out, possibly? I shall give her what she deserves. What the hell? That was all voiced by the guy that does Amir. And it was, well, they made a cutscene out of it pretty much. So is this what they wanted to do and just didn't do it? They had him in the room back here. I would have loved this. Look at it. Trailer magic. Maybe? That was really good. Whoa, this was like 7 years ago, this one. So this might have been one of the first trailers, huh? Get out. All right, well, let's look at some more, shall we? All right, well, we'll make this one the last one. This is from the WitcherCon that was actually recent, but we weren't able, well, I wasn't able to actually watch that. I would have loved to stream that whole thing and just sit here and bullshit with you guys, but, well, we wasn't done with the game yet, so there was no way we could have did it. There was a few more songs in there that I'll probably check out, but this one obviously means probably the most to all of us out of all them songs, because the moment, remember Priscilla doing Wolvenstorm? Amazing. So is this must be a live take of that whole scene, I guess, and they're just redoing it in orchestra or something? But let's go ahead and wash it and take it in and make this the last one.
Fade, berry start, lilac sweet. into the storm to find your heart, its passion displaced by our ever-growing hardening into stone, amidst the call to hold you in a heated embrace. You flee, my dream come the morning, your scent buries dark lilac sweet, to dream of raven locks and twisted stones.
That was really well done. Only thing I can remember, like, it's so crazy because, well, the talent of these people, extraordinary, unbelievable. The thing that I remember most from just listening to that song, remember the end of it when Zoltan's just sitting there doing this? He's like putting his hand up, like singing, but not singing to Geralt with his eyes closed. That shit was so funny, man. I need one more. I can't end it on that note. Let's look at one more because there was one more that jumped out at me. The Ladies of the Woods. So this must be just like the other one we just watched. We have to see this one too. The Ladies of the Wood. Remember that song? It was so creepy. Come on, let's listen to it. Creepy. It was so creepily good. Look at the freaking microphones with the vines around it. Did you see it in the last one? The Priscilla song as well? The Woven's Thorn. Wow, these people are so damn talented. This must have been so awesome to watch live. It would have been so cool to live stream that. Oh. Well, that was it, my friends. That was it. There was other stuff to poke through, but I feel like them ones were probably among the best that I could find in, well, The Witcher's YouTube channel. I'm so happy I can actually browse their YouTube channel now. I'm going to stay on it all the time. I'm going to keep rewatching them. The trailers. The whole 10th anniversary trailer was so good. That was a great... It felt like a send-off, fully. Just a complete send-off to The Witcher. And I love that. It's like what's been happening with Geralt ever since, well, we've been gone. And of course, did him talking to us... That he misses us. You know he misses us. all the damn time we spent with Geralt. He misses us. Well, this is it for the Witcher trailer reactions. Just know that in time, I will be doing a New Game Plus Let's Play at some point. It's interesting how I want to play that out because, well, hold on. Okay, I had to go to this screen. I had to just sit here and look at this one last time. New Game Plus will be a thing for sure. It will come after the whole situation with the new updates with The Witcher. Don't know when that is actually going to be a thing, but it's going to be quite a while. The next Witcher content we will see together will be Thronebreaker. Thronebreaker will be definitely on the channel shortly. Let's just say soon. It will be on the channel soon. And, well, I can't imagine that being a really long game, but even so, it's probably going to take forever. Because when it comes to The Witcher, I just want to sit there and take as much time as I can to play the games. But I'm really looking forward to it. I know it's about Queen Meve, and that's about all I know. So we're going to see what it actually is. I can imagine it's probably going to be on the lines of, if it's following book stuff, it's probably going to be on the lines of when Nilfgaard invaded. That's going to be really awesome to see, and let's hope that Geralt's in it. The only thing that I could picture Geralt being in that story is the whole story with the bridge, when she knighted him. Other than that, I can't imagine Geralt in the story unless they kind of inserted him some way, somehow. But we'll see how it is. And with New Game Plus, it's going to be interesting because I'm not sure how I want to do that. I'm going to get myself prepared, obviously, with the save that we have. I'm going to make sure everything's ready to go. And when we actually get into New Game Plus, I don't believe I'm going to show all the side stuff fully. As in, I'm not talking about the side quests in general, because all the side quests, the Witcher contracts, the main quests, I'm going to show all of that. But I'm talking about the question mark stuff. I don't believe any of that's going to change. And what I'm really striving for is to get back into The Witcher. We know the overarching story of The Witcher, so it's not going to be fully blind. But the other choices, I'm going to make every choice different than I made from the first time. So whatever we made in the first Let's Play, let's just say Geralt was, I want to say that we did pretty good in that. We weren't really an asshole. We might have been at times. This time around, I can imagine it's going to tear me up. Everything is going to tear me up a bit more than what we did the first time. And I'm looking forward to that because it's all brand new stuff that we can see and I can react to. And we can just take it in and discuss all the crazy shit that we're going to do. Like I said, I'll probably do a lot of the exploring and stuff off camera because, well, we already seen that. I don't think that stuff changes. When it comes to all quest stuff, big quest stuff, all side quest stuff, anything with a choice that gives us another choice that we can pick that's opposite from the first one, we're going to do. So I'm really looking forward to it. And as always, my friends, thank you very much for being here with me on the journey through The Witcher. It has been a pleasure to do all this from start to finish. And like I said, for now, we can always remember. And Geralt and them told us now we can always remember all these memories because they are some amazing memories to look back on. But thank you again. Take it easy. See you next time in The Witcher. Have a good one.